Erica, we're recording.
All right, guys, we are here with Roy and Terry, which is my girlfriend's parents. And for the first time, they're gonna watch a really cool video, a video that I think most people know, and it's a very special video, especially in the hip hop community, called Dear Mama by Tupac Shakur. Interesting fact, these people have never seen this video, never heard the song, don't even know who Tupac is. So they're gonna be, I'm excited to introduce them to Tupac and to this song. Do y'all have any questions thus far?
No,
who's
not until I see it.
Right.
Who's Tupac?
Right, who's Tupac?
What's his real name?
And that's his real name.
Really, his mama named him Tupac?
Yeah. Tupac Shakur. Tupac Amaru Shakur. It has a meaning, and I can't remember it.
Okay.
This song was, I believe, came out in 1995. Tupac is a hip-hop artist. Started out in New York, moved down to Baltimore, and then flew out to California, which is most known for being a West Coast artist. And like I said, he actually has a lot of movies. He starred in a few movies.
Really?
He's a very eclectic artist that had a plethora of different talents between acting, poetry, rapping, and, you know, and actually being a activist.
So what kind of name a movie that he was in?
He was in a movie called Gridlock, Poetic Justice with Janet Jackson, A Juice, which is what's his first movie, Above the Rim, which is a movie I love. So he has some decent, good movies.
Cool.
Unfortunately, Tupac was killed in 1996.
Why?
You know, that's still a mystery.
They don't know
why. There's a lot of theories out there, but at the end of the day, you can tell
everybody's just guessing.
Everybody's guessing. But he was killed in Las Vegas as he was shot down. And but it's so funny. Tupac is like our modern day Elvis. Because some people believe he's still alive, right? It's crazy.
Oh, okay. One of those.
Right. And also, he's been dead for over 20 years, and we still listen to his music.
Wow.
So it goes to show how profound his music is. And this is one of his number one hits called Dear Mama. All right. So we're going to play it and maybe stop and start and hear your reaction. All right. One more thing. His mother was part of the Black Panther. And funny enough, his mother was actually pregnant with him while she was in jail.
Wow.
A cool story. She was facing some big federal charges and she decided to represent herself.
Oh.
And she actually beat those charges.
Wow.
Without having a lawyer.
No. She's chewing on that strap.
Tyson. So he comes from a very interesting family. A lot of his family was like Black Panthers, and they was very big on the community and trying to uplift the African American community. All right, here we go. Dear Mama.
Jail, I thought I was going to have a baby and the baby would never be with me.
And that's actually his mom.
I quit it a month and 3 days before Tupac was born. I was real happy.
That's his real mother.
Because I had a son. When I was
young, me and my mama. Another thing. Tupac was actually locked up when this song was made. So Tupac is not actually in this video. So it's so you won't actually see him. He was actually...
There's pictures of him.
Yeah. Technical difficulty. That's my baby. New baby. 6 days old.
He doesn't like it.
Yeah.
Yeah, he played. The minute you start playing, he started crying.
Right.
When I was pregnant in jail, I thought I was going to have a baby and the baby would never be with me, but I was acquitted a month and 3 days before Tupac was born. I was real happy. Because I had a son.
When I was young, me and my mama had beef. 17 years old, kicked out on the streets. Go back into time, I never thought I'd see a face. Ain't a woman alive that could take my mama's place. Suspended from school, scared to go home. I was a fool with the big boys breaking all the rules. Shed tears with my baby sister. Over the years, we was poor and now the little kids. And even though we had different daddies, the same drama with things went wrong, we blame mama. I reminisce on the stress I caused. It was hell, hugging on my mama from a jail cell. Who think in elementary? Hey, I see the penitentiary one day. Running from the police, that's right. Mama catch me, put a whoop into my backside. And even as a crack fiend, mama, you always was the black queen, mama.
quick, his mother really was hooked on cocaine.
Okay. Oh, she was.
She was.
After he was born?
Yes, after he was born. And this is back in the crack epidemic of the 80s.
Yep.
And this is one of the things he had to deal with seeing his mother on drugs.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Finally got to stay at home, woman, it ain't easy. Trying to raise a man. You always was committed. A poor single mother on welfare. Tell me how you did. There's no way I can pay you back. But the plan is to show you that I understand. You all appreciate it.
No love for my daddy, cause the camera wasn't there. He passed away and I didn't cry, cause my anger.
You know, I'm actually not too sure what happened to his father. I think that's just part of the song, but I know his father was not in his life.
Okay.
Yeah.
Wouldn't let me feel for a stranger. They say I'm wrong and I'm heartless. But all along I was looking for a father, he was gone. I hung around with the thugs, and even though they sold drugs, they showed a young brother love. I moved out, started really hanging. Needed money on my own, so I started slanging. I ain't guilty, cause even though I sell rocks, it feels good putting money in your mailbox. I love paying rent when the rent's due. I hope you got the diamond necklace that I sent to you. Cause when I was low, you was there for me. You never left me alone because you cared for me. And I can see you coming home after work late. You're in the kitchen trying to fix us a hot plate. Just working with the scraps you was
making.
No, he actually he actually had a sister.
Brother or sister, yeah.
No.
No, he had a sister.
Yeah, just a sister. Yeah. I believe he had two sisters, but in the song, he's specifically talking about his older sister.
We were cool every Thanksgiving, but now the road got rough, you're alone. Trying to raise two bad kids on your own. And there's no way I can pay you back. But my plan is to show you that I understand. You all appreciate it. When I was sick as a little kid, to keep me happy, there's no limit to the things you did. And all my childhood memories are full of all the sweet things you did for me. And even though I act crazy, I gotta thank you, Lord, that you made me. There are no words that can express how I feel. You never kept a secret, always stayed real. And I appreciate how you raised me. And all the extra love that you gave me. I wish I could take the pain away. If you can make it through the night, there's a brighter day. Everything will be alright if you hold on. It's a struggle every day, gotta roll on. There's no way I...
So,
he got beat up?
Well, he was actually shot 5 times.
He survived?
He did survive it. The first time he was shot, it was in 1995. And this was like a little bit... Before this song came out or after?
Was it drug related because he was dealing with drugs?
No. He actually wasn't dealing with drugs at all. And the drug thing was mostly dealing with his youth. Right. By the time he got shot, he was already a hip hop artist.
Right.
He was in New
York.
But
I mean, the first time he was shot there.
No, exactly.
That was more drug related.
No, it wasn't. So the truth is, Tupac was never a drug dealer.
Okay.
He actually went to a school in Baltimore for performing arts.
Oh, that makes sense.
Yeah, and as he tried to like leave his environment, but he talks about drug dealing, and I think specifically what black kids face being living in the city.
In the city, yes.
But he's not known for himself to being a drug dealer.
Okay.
So sometimes when people rap, they talk about their own life experience or what they see.
Okay.
But he was shot as he was robbed. That's what happened. He was robbed. He was going to a studio and to do more music, and he was shot as he was going up to the studio.
Ah.
You take it back, but my plan is to
things to show you that I understand. You all appreciate it.
It was like more of like a ghost.
Like,
well, not really a ghost. It was more like, because unfortunately, like I said, when this video came out, Tupac was actually locked up, so he couldn't be part of the video.
Right.
So I'm assuming the producers of the videos try to find ways to incorporate Tupac essence in the video.
That's right, Brian, because they showed that scene twice.
So yeah. Why was he locked up?
You
have to ask Amazon.
Well, no. I do know. Unfortunately.
Well, you don't have to tell me if you don't want to.
Yeah. I mean, just to stay with the theme of the song, because that would take us down a whole other path. But this song was really, to me, it was one of the most heartfelt songs you could hear out of hip hop. So y'all can just give me your.
No. I didn't even think it was really hip hop. I thought it was.
I don't really call that hip hop.
Like a ballad or something about his mom. And even though his mom wasn't perfect, but he really realized how much his mom did.
It sounded more like a rhythm and blues because it was very slow.
That's what I got out of it. I thought, man, he finally grew up. He understood what his mom did for him, and he wrote the song. But he told the reality. He was bad.
He was bad. And he showed that this wasn't a perfect upbringing, but he still appreciated what she did, even though it wasn't like I said, picture perfect or anything like that. Still, mom, I still appreciate what you did.
Right. Because, to be born in a situation where as your mother was a former Black Panther, but then she fell a victim to drugs, and to be living in the city, which you face a lot of poverty, a lot of violence, mm-hmm. and all those things. And to be a single mother, and you're trying to raise your kids, and I'm pretty sure she didn't do everything right, but he wanted to tell her, thank you. Like, for instance, my mother, Sherry.
Sherry?
You show him your mother?
Yeah, right. So, I apologize and give a little space for this young lady over here.
Yeah, this young lady.
Right.
This beautiful woman.
Watching this video just made me think about, like I told you, I did a post about this a while back, and how thankful I am for how you raised me, because I know it wasn't easy. And I really thank you. I think this song is like dedicated to any mother. Mm-hmm. I have a father too, right?
He's the one who hooked me up. You don't hear many songs about it.
Yeah, you're right.
It's like 30-something years
ago. Hey, just
so
you know, Gilbert, even in raising your son coming up, not everything goes perfectly the way we want. We just do the best we can.
Right. And I want to try to see this video because it reminds me a little bit of my childhood. My mother wasn't on drugs or anything, but we did. We was raised in some tough neighborhoods, and we had to make some really tough decisions. And I wasn't an easy kid.
No, Gilbert, you didn't speak your mind.
My mother said this morning when I tell him to stay in the house, who was outside?
I definitely was not an easy kid to raise. So. And I appreciate that. I know you did the best you could, and I want y'all to see it. And,
thanks for sharing that. Thank you very much for sharing that.
And
you too, Ollie.
Yeah. I can see.
Don't like that thing.
And
in
her self-sacrifice for us kids, helping us do our homework, and when we were down and out, and maybe got caught cheating at school, she was still there to love you unconditionally.
Exactly.
Unconditional love.
So. Appreciate you guys taking part in this, and that's all I got.